Pictures are the same way. You can either create a frame with this one with the X through it. That's pretty typical in our field, is whenever you have a box with an X through it, it means for placement only, or FPO. So I can either draw a frame first, just like I did with the text, and go file place, and navigate to one of my images, okay? Or I cannot have anything selected and just go file place, grab my other image, I get a loaded cursor like I did before, and if I click, it will just bring that image in at full size. There's really not a preferred method. You can see that when I just click, I get the whole image. When I created a frame, it actually cut off part of the image, which isn't a big deal. I can just resize the frame just like I did for the text, and we can see it all. Okay. Hopefully you remember that in Illustrator, there was a black arrow tool and a white arrow tool. The black selected the whole thing, and the white selected individual points. Okay. In this case, the white actually selects the content. So I can move the content around within the frame. They're two totally different things. And that's one of the key things about InDesign, is that everything's in a frame, and the frame is different than the content. They're two individual things, just like in real life. You've got a photo, and you've got the frame that contains it. So I can move the content within the frame, or I could just move the whole frame itself. That's the difference between the black and white arrow in InDesign. It's black moves the frame, white moves the content. So I could position that pumpkin up here. If I want to make it smaller, I actually would have to watch what happens here. You would think if I just grab the corner, it would change the whole size, correct? But because I have the black arrow, it just changed the frame size. I actually would have to click on the white arrow and change. You see how that bounding box is a brown color now? Then I could just change the image size. They're two independent things from each other, which is kind of nice. Like if you just want to do kind of a special effect where I don't really need all this table setting. I just want the pie. So I can just resize the frame, and do you see how it masks in a really simple way? Okay, we had to go through a lot of steps to get something like that to happen in Photoshop or Illustrator. But if I just use my black arrow tool, I can trim the things off that I don't want and just get that pie. Now, if I want to make the frame and the content smaller, of course there's a shortcut for that. If you were to hold down Command while you are resizing the frame, it'll also resize the content. Okay. So here's my layout program. I've got two images and text, pretty easy to bring in. Another unique concept that I want to bring up about InDesign before I finish this lesson is something called runaround. This goes back to Quark, which was a predecessor of InDesign. And what it has to do is the interaction between frames. Okay, you could see that this image has no problem just covering up the text. Okay, and in InDesign, we did things like arrange, send to back, which I can do here. But that's not really a good effect either, because it's not readable. We can't read that text over that pie. So instead, I'm actually going to choose this image and go Object. Oops. And then you could set things like the clipping path. We'll go into that more later. What I really want to do is actually window text wrap. Okay, runaround is the more formal term of it. Text wrap is what InDesign calls it. But if you go window text wrap, it should really be up all the time. This will determine the interaction between frames. Okay, so I have the frame that holds the pumpkin pie selected, and the first text wrap option is selected, which means no text wrap, meaning that whatever is on top and there's no interaction. If I click that second button, which says wrap around bounding box, can you see how it pushes the text wherever I put it now? It's almost like it has this force field where it's pushing everything away from it. So if you have text wrap, it will actually push the other content away from it. And you can control how far away by controlling these little numbers here. This determines how far away from the image everything will be. There's a couple of other options as well, like you just want it above and below or just above. I'm going to keep it just at this basic one, which just means that there's wrap around the bounding box. And I'm going to move this a a little bit over. Let's say I just want this to bump the ingredients over. So I can just kind of push that over. You can see how it responds to the image. And if I'm worried about that becoming printed off, that's fine, because I could just change the frame. And maybe I only want a little snippet of pumpkin pie. Or, remember, the frame and the content are separate. So I can go to the white arrow, and I could actually position the image differently in the frame to maybe get a better image. Okay, so they're two different things. As far as this pumpkin goes, same thing. Right now he has no runaround or text wrap, so he's just covering up things. If I choose that option, the bounding box will push away from it. But because this image has nice white space around it, which we can prepare in Photoshop, I can actually go to that third option, which will wrap around the object shape, and it will actually get right up against the pumpkin rather than around the box. And we can tweak that with options that I will show you at a later time. So we can actually really bring things right up around that pumpkin if we want. Now, I could see that with all my maneuvering, I've actually clipped off some of my text, because you could see that red plus sign, which is what we're trying to avoid. So I'm probably just going to make my frame a little bit bigger, and I could fit that in there then. And obviously, I got to move my pumpkin over. And let's take a look at that. I'm going to double click on my hand tool, and you can see the layout of my recipe page. If you really want a true idea of what it's going to look like aside from printing, you can see there's all these margins and boxes on the screen. Another unique thing in InDesign is the preview button. It's at the very bottom of your toolbar, and if you click and hold on it, you can actually choose preview, and then you could see that all of those lines go away, and you just get what the image will look like. Okay, so typically I work with those on, just so that we have an idea of what we're working with, but it's nice to be able to turn those off. So InDesign is a pretty simple to use layout program where we can bring in elements from other programs. I'm just going to save this file, which will give it an INDD extension for InDesign document. And I'm just going to save that to the same folder where the text and the images are. It's a really important step that you always start with a folder, because these images aren't truly in the document. They're links to the document, and we can't break that link. So I'm just going to save this file into that same folder so everything's in one spot and I can find it to replace it or fix it later on. And that's an introduction to InDesign.